Hi, I'm Barbara, the co-CEO of 100% Renewables. We're a consultancy that specializes in the development of climate action strategies. And in today's video, I'll be talking about Scope 3 emission sources. Scope 3 emissions happen upstream and downstream of your business. Examples are waste, air travel, the consumption of goods and services, contractor emissions, or leased assets. According to the Greenhouse Gas Protocol, specifically the Corporate Value Chain Accounting and Reporting Standard, there are 15 categories of Scope 3 emissions. Keen to hear what they are? It's going to be a long list. Here it is. Let's start with upstream emissions first. Category number one is purchased goods and services. This is pretty self-explanatory. It's what your business buys on a daily basis, such as stationery or professional services. Category number two is capital goods. This is equipment that you use for manufacturing your product or providing your service. Category number three is upstream fuel and energy related emissions, such as transmission and distribution losses for your electricity, or emissions related to the production of transport fuels such as diesel. Category number four is upstream transportation and distribution. This emission source relates to getting products delivered to your business using third-party transportation providers. Category number five is waste. Waste that's generated in your operations. These are emissions from third-party disposal and the treatment of waste. Category six is business travel. This is emissions caused by the transportation of your employees for business-related activities in vehicles that are owned or operated by third parties, such as aircraft, trains, buses, and passenger cars, such as taxis. Category seven is employee commuting. This accounts for travel between your staff homes and your business. Category 8 is upstream leased assets. This emission source comes from assets that you rent that are not already included in your Scope 1 and Scope 2 inventory.